Hello everyone, my friends, my name is Artem Lubimov and I'm art director of Moscow Hairdressing Academy. The purpose of this course is to let any master of any working experience to work and to get really great results. Everything is broken down by pieces from A to Z. Everything will be spelled out and I hope that all of you will succeed in this. So I wouldn't delay anymore. Let's get started. Okay, so let's try to investigate this haircut. I like it because it's graduation, which is the key part of this particular haircut. Turns out to be really spectacular. It lets you control the shape, and it is done the way that lets you keep all sections in one finger. I mean, it's very convenient for juniors. So this haircut can be chosen by those of you who do not feel confident enough, for example, to move on long lines yet, but the results looks like you really did fantastic job. Let's try to understand the theory. I'm going to draw a few heads. And we are going to look at the areas. So when we do the cutting, our task is to look from the model's back and look on this point, from the highest point of the head to the edge point. And on the straight line, we need to divide this line into three main parts. And in the area of the first part, we need to make horizontal parting. To detach the lower back area, when we move to second part. It gets into this horseshoe area and the middle back of the head, between the horseshoe and lower back area. We start walking with the lowest part. Our first priority task is to determine the length. Whether your hair is long or short, the first thing you need to do is to comb the hair and determine the shape line. So you comb, the hair just falls down naturally, and you cut them as soon as the length is determined. Then, let's take this part. It suits the finger length the perfect way. So you are not supposed to have any difficulties with graduation. All you need to do is to move on, carefully, step by step. Actually, there are no any pitfalls. It's really very simple. We detach the first section, the contour section. Usually I paint over all contour sections in my notes. So, we take it. We comb at 45 degrees. And determine the cut line. The line is visual and distribution is T to the parting. So we comb the section on ourselves this way. We have the parting here. And here is the perpendicular section. So we are standing behind. We direct the section towards and cut it here. Okay, we've got it. I think I should draw it a bit longer. This way. After that, as soon as we cut it, this section will be the control one, we move on. First, to the left side. We are going to move on parallel partings. We take the part of the previous section, then the next section, then again. We had the first one here, it was T to the parting. The second one will be T to the parting as well. Again, we have 45 degrees elevation. And we are going to follow the control section. We cut it and repeat again. It will be T to the pattern as well, so you have each section directed towards to you. You stand behind, and you need to control the exact perpendicular to the parting. Make sure it's directed backwards. Even then the head is starting to turn this way, you do not follow this turning. You like pull it back. In each next sections you work with will be the same shape, but different in length. So here the head is turning round, that means the next section will be longer. So you could keep the graduation shape. We have it. Then you have this gap. Instead of taking the next section and reaching the borderline, you'll not take the whole section, but just a little part of it. So what you are going to do is just like isolating everything that relates to the borderline, about 1 centimeter or 1.5. So you isolate it and don't touch it all. But this triangle will be over-directed to last section. The distribution is over-direction and elevation is 45 degrees. If you leave this borderline, you will also have edging angle, which is very important. Only this part will be using layers. The way you are going to work with it is absolutely the same. The point that makes this technique unique is that in each step you simply repeat the same process, in fact. All you need to learn is just distribution, T to the parting. Towards. Also, you need to learn how to align with the previous section. And of course, to keep elevation. After you have cut this spot, you did it on one side, you did it on the other side. But here, you isolate the borderline and you don't cut it. It's not cut here, not cut there. So you keep these corners, which are very important for working with edging then. When we move to the next part? No, we dry it, straighten out a bit, shape it and personalize. Do the edging, now it's finishing one, and proceed to the next part. Here we do all the same things the same way. We stop with profile section. It's also going to be the control one. And then we take it in order to make the first cut. We direct it perpendicularly to the parting, back and towards. We take the previous section and continue the line. We keep 45 degrees and make this graduation line. After we have done that, we start taking absolutely the same partings. Each of them should be directed towards in 45 degrees. So we cut everything here the same way, except for the moment when we had the borderline behind the ear. It's the first time we don't cut it here. We isolate it and it's not supposed to be cut. Moreover, this hair we don't cut as well. All this stuff. But this whole triangle we over-direct the same way as we did with the last one here. We'll over-direct it to the previous section. So we have both graduation and elongation. And our secured length is here. So technique is very universal. Then we move on to the top. There are a lot of ways to work with the top, but they are all about over-directing the hair backwards, through the highest point. And then you continue doing this technique. Here you can make the profile parting same way. And here, work with parallel partings and over-direct everything the same way. We lose the crown and connect with the elongation we got on the temporal area. we have this elongation due to performing over direction, so we connect the crown with the temple. But we can take, for example, the control section here and cut graduation if you want to make it lighter. So this technique requires minimum efforts, but the results just fascinating. I do like it. And what I like as well is that this technique can be done by any beginner. So this is really simple way of graduation and pretty impressive haircut, 2-in-1. Then, as we know all the theory, we can move on and create this haircut, face all the pitfalls, learn all mistakes and maybe some tough things. Yeah, there are some details that are worth paying attention, but we have just discussed them, so we just need to work with the texture very gently. At each stage we dry, personalize and connect every next part of the haircut with the previous one, so we get all the necessary control and quality. So let's try. Okay, so we start to walk. I want you to notice from the very beginning, here we have the particular length. The hair is blonde and lightened. I call this haircut child's graduation. Why? Because everything is so clear, intelligible and easy, that if any junior wants to learn the graduation technique, we would probably start with this one. Result is really excellent and great. So what does we start with? We start with profile parting. As always, you need to find the nose tip. We put the comb on hairline and then we move it. Move to the back of the head. Let me show you from here, so you could see what I do. We move the comb, move it to the back of the head, and then we make a parting. Then we start combing it out. To the one side, then to the other side. Great. Then, let's imagine that we need to divide all this height from the highest point to the nape into 3 equal parts. This way, here. 1, 2. We fix this point in the first part, the first third, and make a horizontal parting. We take the horizontal parting to the top of the ear. Like this. Now we need to make sure that the parting is straight enough. All the rest hair we secure. It's because we are going to work with this part at the moment. First, we are going to work with the whole nape area to make the graduation. After that, edging. And of course, texture. We are going to finish the section before moving on. So initially, you need to spend more time on this area. We make the partings open and clean. This way. You know, I think that this one should be elevated a bit. How many of you have noticed that I should have been elevated? Raise your hands. Here is your chocolate for you. Of course, I'm just kidding. We produce no chocolate. And you are not going to get any chocolate at the moment. But if you have noticed that the side was a bit lower, it is very, very good. Okay. We took the parting. So now we can start cutting. On the same time, we'll see what we got here, if we elevate all this stuff. Well, here I think the hairline is almost perfect. I wish everyone has the same. So we are going to determine the borderline. First we comb everything. Distribution is natural fall, elevation is zero. And we also need to determine the length. We determine the length, and to help ourselves we are going to create the shape about a half centimeter longer than we want. So this line is going to be like a draft. Let's try to make it. For example, I want it to be like this. That means I'm going to cut a bit longer, about 5 millimeters. And I start cutting it. And I don't care much about accuracy. I don't care about anything. I just cut as it goes. The first side. And then I move to the other side. The only thing you need to care about initially is that you need to make it symmetric, without any serious skewnesses. Of course, you'll continue working on it, shaping it up and so on, but initially it needs to be symmetric. So now I'm going to work on it. I mean to work on this issue. Okay, it's done. Now we start working with the profile section. We create our control section. The thickness is about 1 centimeter. Till I haven't started yet, I wet the hair once again. Okay, let's try to figure out what we need to do. We have the horizontal parting. The elevation is 45 degrees. Here we have 90, here 45. The distribution will be T to the parting. As we have the parting here, the perpendicular will be located this way. That's why all the sections we are going to create will be perpendicular to the parting as well. This way. All these sections will have elevation 45. And they all will follow the control visual line, which we are going to create. The head should be tilted a bit. I comb it out from the roots. I create the first control line. The elevation is about 45 degrees. As you can see, the section can easily be held in fingers. That's why you can cut it very easily. we get the outline this way. Next. This way I had the section T to the parting and 45 degrees. Then I take the next section, which is parallel to the first one. Here it is. And it is going to be perpendicular to the parting the same way. So I'm going to follow the previous section. I comb it out again from the roots, keeping the elevation. As you can see, I have the section distributed again, T to the parting. Here is the parting and here is the section. Then I'll have the next one, the next, so each section will be directed backwards, T to the parting. It's very important, that's why I keep repeating it. Because if you start steering it over there, not just on the perpendicular, the graduation will be disrupted. But here you have an opportunity to achieve good result with less effort, so you need to stay concentrated. Let's try to cut it. So I keep the distribution perpendicular to the parting. I see control section, here it is, and I cut. Then I take the next vertical parting. The part of cut section and comb it out again, perpendicular to the parting. So it is directed backwards, like this. Okay, now we try to cut it. We take the next section. We comb it out. Distribution should be T to the parting. That's it. I cut in the control section, which I can observe very well. Great, so here I reached a particular stage. Here we have the last section. And we need to perform the following thing here. We take this section, elevate it, we look on edge line. And along the edge line, we detach approximately 1 centimeter. We do it like this. Then we lower it here. And the part that was elevated, this one, and the detached one, we are going to over-direct it to the previous section that has been cut. I mean, we detach the last section and over-direct all the stuff to it. We don't change any elevation. I cut very little here. This way. So here I have the borderline left, and the last section itself was over-directed here to the last one that was cut. Then I can move on the other side. Then we detach the central control section again. All these sections are combed out to the left side, so they wouldn't disturb us, and we are going to move to the right side. Still, I can hold my hands as I prefer. For example, this is not the key moment. You cannot turn the fingers. You can keep it this way. You can keep the position of your hands and keep your thumbs up. We comb it out from the roots and right from the parting. And here again, the start with same thing. perpendicular to the parting. The elevation is 45 degrees. And we cut by the guide. By the control section. Then we take the parallel parting. We take part from this cut area and we comb it out again. And distribute it back. Of course, I feel like turning my hand out. It's more convenient for me. That's why I have turned it, but it wasn't necessary. We cut it. Then we do the same thing again. We take the borderline, elevate it, mark 1 centimeter, and then we over-direct the triangle that was left in the last section. Here it is. Then we need to dry everything. We need to clean it, create personalization, and get the accurate edge and line. So let's do that. In order to do this, you need to dry out all the roots and all the hair within the natural fall, so that it fall down naturally. But do not over-direct it. You maybe curl at the ends a bit, but do not much, like this. Just give a little bend. Here I have dried all the hair within the natural fall. And now, before making the edging, I would like to remove the baby hair. They may not let me do this. I shave it here, but I keep in mind that my border is almost perfect here. That's why I don't shave it too high. I do it lightly. First, I remove it in the center, as you can see. Then, I remove it in one side and then in the other side. I shave it a bit and comb. That's done. Now I need to work with the texture right now. I keep the sections horizontally. Keep the comb on the straight line. So I start to ease this borderline horizontally as well. My task here is to save the outline, so I can't change it by any means. All I need is just to thin the endings a bit. And I do it on each level. First I do it on the highest one, then I take the lower one. Then I take lower again. Then I take it much lower. First, I've done it with the central part. When I start taking sections right here, you can see that all the sections were distributed this way, perpendicular to the parting, so I have cut it by the guide. So, you see, I have flat geometric plane here. I mean, I was keeping the outline of the haircut. And right from the top part of the sections, I cut it out, like this. And then I softened the line. I have one important point here. Then I walk, I soften the border directly. And I do not insert the scissors too deep. It's because the graduation itself is a volume. And if I insert the scissors too deep, I will put away a large amount of volume. I don't need it. So I use my head, thinking logically, and I understand that I need to remove just some part of the volume at the ends. This will give me a chance to walk smoother. Here I make it to the left, and then I make it to the right. I start from the highest part of the hair again. I take the highest layer, which is kept on geometric shape. Then I move lower. Then I move lower again. So far, I don't think that I have cut enough. Then I start creating the control line. As I told you, I will raise it by half a centimeter. So I keep my word. And I raise it by half a centimeter. And start to create the border using pointing. So please pay attention that I cut it, then I comb it out and clean it up again in case if something gets out there. If nothing gets out, then this border will be very comfortable in wearing. My task here is to look carefully. So do not be afraid to look directly under the line. You really should be able to spend more time working with it. It's your value. That's what you get paid for. Clarity and quality affect the final cost of your haircut. And it's all about how your clients and their friends perceive the haircut. Well, I have worked out in one direction, now I'm starting to walk in the opposite direction. I continue to move using pointing, and I try to maintain the symmetry. This way. I am looking on this spot. I feel like satisfied. Now we can look on the outline, which is starting to be clear. Please pay attention to the fact that the outline is very soft. And we can already notice the first stage of graduation. From this point, we'll make a little elongation, but not at the moment. Now we think about the graduation. And now we'll move on. So now we're going to start with the middle nape area and temporal area. That's why we need to detach the horseshoe. It will be our next zone. How do we detach the horseshoe? We comb the hair up. We have baby hair here, but you shouldn't care about them. Actually, you don't need to take them seriously. This point is the top of our recessions. We put our comb here at the top and move it straight ahead this way. We fixed it here. Then I take it from the left side, I stand against the client's face, and then I take it from the right side, I stand behind. Again, I find the point, I comb the hair up like this, I see the point, and move forward. I divide it from one side, then from another side, then I put away the clip and connect it. So this hair is divided here, and this hair is combed out here. Well, the whole top area is secured. Well, let's secure it, he said to her. I comb it out. I have twisted it all here on the top of the head. It's like a shell. And I have pinched the tail. And now I've got the following working area. I remove the temporal areas from here. How do I do this? I just take them along the line of radial parting. I have it here from ear to ear. Well, it can't go from here, but it can go there, because this area already exists, from one side and from another. Now we can continue working with our graduation. How do we do it? We repeat the technique. We take the profile section again. Not very thick, something about 1.5 centimeters. Also, we take the profile parting, which used to be the first control section. We take the first control section and take the second control section. Then we tilt the head a bit and make this kind of line. We keep the elevation and see how our line is directed. We keep 45 degrees and look. Our line is going this way, so we continue moving it the same way. We've done it. Now we have the control section for second level. Here we repeat all the same things. This way we get the horizontal parting. This way we get the perpendicular to the parting. All sections are going to be directed backwards. So we'll have the elevation 45 degrees for all of them. And each of them will be aligned with the previous one. So let's move on parallel partings and with parallel sections. We have one more parting. And the next one. And now again, we comb it out from the root. From the very root. You see, as I get inside with a comb. Because this is one of the basic things of creating a successful haircut. So you can keep the outline. It means you take the lower section and then continue it. So you have all the outline completed. We take parallel section. We take the previously cut section. We comb it out from the roots. We check distribution, whether we have the perpendicular here. Look on the control line. I can see it. And we cut. When we move forward, look, we reach this point and we have some space left. We are looking for the borderline again. We leave this much from the border here, but we take all this and over-direct it to the last section, to this one. We leave it here. But this stuff, we over-direct it here. It means the distribution is over-direction here. And we work along the guide. We have to see it very well. We just comb all this here. And we just cut close to the borderline, but we do not trim it. Then we move to the next side. We detach the profile section again. We detach the section nearby. Comb out from the roots. We keep the 45 degrees elevation. Find the control section. Then we take another parallel section. And now, then we have such an end left here. We take 1 or 1.5 centimeter along the border. We leave it. Over direct all this part to the last section. The distribution is over direction too. At the same time, the head keeps its position. It is tilted. So it should be tilted. I did it. And the section should be cut closely to the control one. So it's done. All we need to do now is to work with this part of graduation. To do this, we dry it out within the natural fall. Let's look at the graduation and let's soften the texture. So I have dried the hair and now we need to bring together first layer and the second one, so that to work with the personalization. For that, we need, of course, to soften the second layer. And we will take some vertical sections. Just go through them and thin them out by around 1 centimeter from the ends. We have to make the strong thinning so that they are like transparent, and so that we have a smooth transition between the first layer and the second one. We over-direct it. We do all the personalization in the same position in which the sections were cut. For example, we have to do a lot of texture now. Please note, if I did it wrong, like that, I would get tired to do so. I would be tired and wouldn't wish to work with it properly. So the only solution here is to work with only one thumb. You work this way here. So you start to soften it. We have our borderline there. It didn't get in. And here we have those layers which got in, which were cut. You see, I was working and this line was softened dramatically. And now I work in the other direction. I have the line softened there, but I haven't softened it here yet. So I start to move to the right side. I do it the same way with the parallel sections. I distribute them just the way they were cut. Then I take the last section. Layers are separated. As you can see, I thin out this side hair hard enough. Leave only the contour. I thin it out hard enough, so I have these side sections here. They are not connected yet. Okay, let's see. We need to trim it and make it connected with the whole haircut. Let's look how our cut has been performed. If necessary, we clean it up again and just compare with what we have left over there. So we do the same thing on the other side. If I want, I can, for example, make the texture a little bit deeper on the lower back of the head, just because I want to do it visually. You see, here it ends, the color is a little bit dirty. White color shades into beige one. And of course, in order to soften it, I make texture a little bit deeper. When I did all this, I could see the outline, which I got here. One way and the other way. I observe it from one side and from the other side. You see, the technique is very simple and it gives an excellent and soft thin eventually. And what we need to do now is to detach the top of the head. We connect these two parts. We leave the top area behind. The result is the following area. As you can see, here we have a semicircle and radial parting from ear to ear. In order to make the graduation, we need to repeat our technique again. So we wet the parting out again. I mean the parting between dry and wet areas. Start taking the profile parting. We take the section in the center. Then we have the 45 degrees elevation again. Distribution is T to the parting again, this way. So, I mean, all sections will be distributed this way. Here and back again. And the cut line will be on the guide. Watch the head to be tilted. We comb everything out from the roots. You see, I comb everything. I see, as I have directed my line here, and just the same way I direct this line here. Let's double check it, if I like it. Just a bit would be okay. I corrected it. Then I move on with parallel buttons again. As you can see, I keep T to the button 45 degrees. We take a small part of the previous section. And I comb from the roots. By the way, combing from the roots is an extremely important point here. Don't forget that you don't need to pull this section so hard. And you cut it by the guide. You see, the shape itself is very easy to be constructed here. The only thing you need to watch is for position of your client's head. It's desirable that it is absolutely still, not as I have in this case. Some neat, slow knuckles gently roll here, all by themselves. I can't even watch them. I keep T to the parting. All the sections go towards from the parting this way. So I have the last section left on the right side. It's done. My graduation is ready. So let's try it. Now I have straightened the hair. So I can start working with the personalization on the highest layer. Again, I take the profile parting, distribute it the same way as I cut. And I continue to soften the top layer from the place where the texture of previous layer was over. I have softened it, combed it out, and I've done it again. I repeat this process until I'm visually satisfied with it, until it's enough. This way, like this, I know that I left the line here, and now I have enough personalization here. I take the next section, and I soften it from the same place again, like the last time. I don't change the outline. This is the most important point. Then I take the next section and soften it again. That's good. Then we work to the other direction. The right one. I work toward the left side. I'm taking the sections. If I don't feel like it's enough, I can take it horizontally. If I still don't feel that, I can do that again. I look and I decide how many of them I need to take. Then I decide if I like them to be soft, how they are organized together, whether I like the texture, and so on. And look at the outline, of course. The outline is great. Okay, now we've done the cutting on the back part of the head, and all we need to do now is to work with the front near the face. Of course, things that there are left are the most important. We need to decide the length, parting, emphasis here. Now we have the temporal and the crown area left. Let's try to complete it. We continue working on this haircut. We lose the temporal areas and soak the partings, as always. Between dry and wet areas, we do it. We soak both. And once we have loosed them, we comb them out immediately. Distribution is natural fall. We comb out the radial parting. So we comb out the tempo as well. We comb everything from one side and then from the other side. Now here, behind the ear, we find the point. The point where the cut hair and not cut hair meet together. To better see this point, you can tilt the model's back head. And comb it like this again. Now you are going to see where this point is located. It turns to be here, yes. Now we need to make a line for elongation. Like, for example, visual line. Or we can not to make the elongation too big, or just make a little one. So you need to think about it looking in the mirror. And as soon as you make the decision, you need to move this line. But not from the connecting point. You need to take about 1 centimeter lower from this point. And from this point you move your line. How to do that? There is no way. You just look on it and cut as you see. Like this. And then you do the same thing on the other side. You comb it out, find the place they are crossing, and then choose the section which is 1 centimeter longer. And make the same drafting cut on the temple. Next. We remember the borderline to be secured. That's why we move it this way, keeping the borderline itself. And this triangle, which is located on the temporal area, is completely over-directed backwards and connect with this gradation on the back. We have even the control section here, so we cut by the guide without touching the edge line itself. As you can see, we don't touch it. And we do the same thing on the other side. We cut it, we connect on the length, and we use this internal triangle, then working with layers. So we have the borderline left, but this internal triangle should be over-directed to our graduation. We comb it out. So now everything is connected with our layers. You see, nothing tricky about this manipulation, because it's just a draft. But when we dry the hair in natural way, the hardest thing, okay, not the hardest, just the most important thing, will be to organize this back line and continue it with the temporal line, in order to keep the elongation we've planned to perform. So let's try to do that. Okay, so I'll pull the temporal areas again. So now I can tilt it a bit and turn the head over. Look how I have the section loosed. And I think this is one of the best things that I could be done ever. So now I can personalize the whole line in a visual way. You see, I have this blondie so tanned here that this line is pretty clear. But I think from your perspective it seems to be merged. It can be observed this way. Then I straighten, turn it over, tilt again, and I comb the hair this way. You can see how I do that. I hope you can observe it. But maybe it's not so clear in the video. Okay, let's see. It would be great, of course, if you get the symmetrical temples. Check in front of the mirror whether they're symmetrical. Next, we start to work with the texture. I take the temple and comb it out without any elevation. If I need to clean up something, I clean it up here. I soften the ends at about 1 centimeter depth. It's called deep parallel point cut. Then the other side. I take the temple standing behind. No elevation. And I made it softer. Then I take those triangles that I was over-directing and trimming according with the edging. So I take them, over-direct them the same direction and soften them on the same position that they have been cut. You see, I split this stuff and now I have these layers much, much lighter. Then here, you see, it looks heavy. Then I take this triangle, over-direct it back the same way like it has been cut. I soften it and bring down. Feels better. Feels much better, I would say. So I'm looking. Sometimes if I feel that the line is not perfect enough, I clean it a bit. Now we have the top area left. I think it's the last step in doing this haircut, and we need to work it out. We start working with the crown area and fringe area. So we need to wet the partings between dry and wet areas. And we start from this point. I can say that the top is twisted here in this direction, to the right. And so the main focus will go, well, like all the hair goes here, before the side parting will be moved to the left. And if the parting is moved to the left, we start to cut from the right side. Here we go from the right side and start to divide with such 1 centimeter thick sections. And we over-directed here, focusing on the temporal area. We take the control section here. So we make a kind of little elevation, maybe like 30 degrees. And we start to cut all this area, focusing on this guide. First section is ready. Then we take the next one. I over-direct it the same way again. Again, I keep the 30 degrees elevation. Then I'm working on the guide again. Then I take 1 or 1.5 centimeter again. I throw it over here again. And again, I work with the elevation of 30 degrees. Distribution is natural fall. Look, there is nothing left here. As you see, the leftmost section is left. I comb it out entirely and over-direct to the right side. But can you imagine, I have some droplets here at the ends. Good. Now we start to do the same to the other side. From this side. We take the first section in this direction. And we take the temporal area, our guide. Here is the control section. This is our guide. Then another 1.5 centimeters. Then again, 1.5. Elevation is 30 degrees. Again, 1.5. So I pass the crown area with parallel partings like this. Well, now I have nothing here. If it is nothing, it's nothing. That means it's all right. Then I need to dry all the stuff. You see, I got an accent that is shifted to the right side. The fringe in this haircut was quite small initially. I decided not to touch it. I was working right now without regard to the fact that it was like this. Well, let's try it out and try to get our result. Well, I tried it, straightened it out, and now I look at the result so that some hair won't go over my graduation this way. So I detach radial parting from the highest point of the head. And I start cutting this hair with an elevation about 30 degrees, focusing on the guide in the graduation. And I not just cut, but I clear the texture at the same time. So the hair is very, very light. And this hair as well. Well, I only need to soften the temporal areas. It's because the layers are being connected at the moment. I stand behind, comb it out to face, and pass through the ends. This is just a visual work, and there are no common rules for it. I just connect the top layer with something that I got on the bottom. I have worked with stuff below very carefully and drew the definite line, but the stuff at the top is just mine. I would say though, just my artistic vision. The way I do it right now. I have created this elongation on the right side. It was just my wish. The way I connect the texture at the moment, how easy it will be, that's also my wish. I mean, we have a combination of strict rules when we do have to leave it here to keep distribution, elevation, border. We have combination of these strict rules and your personal vision. And then these things are combined. We have the rules of how to break the rules. So I see the control. I cut all the stuff along this control line. I noticed that the hair is on the top area, behind the radial parting, and I don't pull it back. I do not need it here, I just pull only that hair that is at the back of the radial parting, closer to the back of the head. I over-direct it here, because it can get here. I do not pull the hair at the temples, it cannot get here anyway. Now I look. For example, I can make this elongation a little bit shorter. I made it shorter. I made it with point cut. Maybe we have to make the very end a little bit more point cut. Just a little bit. Just symbolically. So we can see there was a fringe. It had an elongation in one side, and hair was shorter on the other side. I can say that probably I like it, so I will not touch it anyway. Now I will work out visually and see if I like my personalization. I turn her to the mirror and turn on slow and cold air. No, the fast mode. And I blow it away. I'm looking around if I like the texture and what is it like. I saw that I forgot to make texture on these layers. I'm looking on the outline. And as I often advise you at the end, it's necessary to check the softness of the graduation lines and the clarity of border lines once again. Therefore, this is what I do now, I think. I make it softer a bit again. But I would not do that if I had the same color here. And now, of course, I feel like I just want to get here and clean it up and make the color look the same. Now we will check the whole border once again. It's necessary to make sure that it's still and whether the head looks symmetrical. So clean it up once again. A final cleaning, I would say. Here we have the elongation of the temple. I finished the cutting here. The line started to lengthen dramatically. I create the same line on the other side. And if I want to add a bit texture or make it a bit lighter, to make this passage look a bit lighter, now it's the best time to do it. Like she's starring in a clip, gesturing her hands. Here's our bob. Speaking about the outline, of course, it's great and very, very soft. Look, we have a very soft graduation, a very beautiful dramatical elongation here. Then a little dissymmetry. It's accentuated on the right. Also here we have a dramatical elongation, beautiful outline. Well, in general, once again, we can see how well light and white hair looks on the tanned blonde with blue eyes. Here's it. So what do I want to tell you? Do your best. Do your best. I look at these works that you often send me for my evaluation. They send this view, side view, send, for example, some silhouettes. But it's clear that the hair cut is not completed. You didn't not your best. Put her at the end. Look, at first glance, it seems that everything is perfect, like it's ready. But she moves back, and I know that I want to clean up this line behind a little bit to make it even clearer, and I make it the straight way. Sometimes I feel like you don't want to finish the whole job up to the end. A lot of you wrote in your feedback that God lives in details. Okay, but the details are very important indeed. So it's very, very sad. Then you don't want to focus on them. Okay, now I'm satisfied with the line and I'm happy. I want you really to try this haircut. It looks just fantastic.